today we're going to make my preserved lemon chicken. It's really a super flavorful roast chicken. I love a good roast chicken. Doesn't matter how you prepare it, but this is one of the best ways. And the juices that come from this chicken are so amazing. I just can't wait to dig into this after it's cooked. So I'm just taking the leaves off some rosemary. I'm going to use those in just a bit. First, I'm going to cut up just a few root vegetables to put in the chicken. These are little new potatoes. I'm going to cut them in half and just put them in my bowl here. It's nice to give yourself a base for your chicken to bake on, to roast on. So I'm going to top and tail these carrots. I didn't peel them. The peels actually have a lot of nutritional value, so I leave them on whenever possible. I'm going to put those right in there as well. The further you get up in the carrot, the thick part, cut them a little bit smaller. That way they'll all cook at the same time. There we go. I'm going to just do a little olive oil. And a little salt and pepper to my carrots and potatoes. So there's a great start. And some of this rosemary is going to go down here too. I just want to give it a good chop because I don't want the bigger pieces of rosemary. I just want the real fine pieces of rosemary. It'll be great, great, great in this. So just a little bit in the root veg down there, and the rest will go on top of my chicken, along with some peeled garlic cloves. And I'm not going to chop up the garlic because I don't really want it to burn. It's going to roast for a long time, so just doing it thusly. When you have a clove of garlic, you just smash it like that, and the peel comes off pretty easily. So, these peels out of the way. Okay, now, with my garlic and my rosemary aside, before I do anything else, I need to put the chicken in. So, I'm going to try to not touch it just yet, because I have to wash my hands as soon as I touch it. So before I do anything else, I'm just going to kind of slather it with some olive oil. That's going to make it nice and golden. And then salt and pepper. And be careful with the amount of salt, because preserved lemon is actually lemons that are preserved in salt. It's an interesting thing to think about, and you get it in the Mediterranean section of your local grocery store or any specialty food store. But it's a really fabulous condiment. It adds so much flavor to things. You can, of course, buy it online. Pepper on this. Decent amount. Now, here comes the secret sauce. I'm going to go ahead and put some garlic in here, too. And use this. So some of this preserved lemon will be just like a paste, and some, like this piece right here, is more whole. That's probably enough. So what I want to do, now that I'm going to go in with my hands, is I'm going to take the stuff that's a paste and just rub it over the skin. And I tell you, when this combines with the chicken juices, these pieces here go right in the cavity. They give it some awesome flavor. But when the juices from the chicken run down with this wonderful, flavorful preserved lemon that's going on in here, I'm telling you, it makes a wonderful pan sauce or make a gravy. I'm going to put a couple of the garlic cloves in the cavity as well. And then the rest and the rosemary, just all around there. And I want to tuck the wings under so they don't burn as the bird roasts. Come on, guy, get in there. He's being a little stubborn. There we go. So that looks pretty amazing already. So my oven is set on 425. I'm going to roast this for about an hour. I think this was about 3.5 pound bird. So we're going to roast it for about an hour, and it's going to come out golden because we've got some olive oil in here. And that lemon is going to be absolutely fabulous. Trust me, you're going to want to try this. Best roast chicken you've ever had.